How do we know which laws from the Old Testament apply? How come we do wear blended fabrics? How come we don't have fences around our rooftop? Why do we eat pork? Well, it's because we understand this genre. So there are three ways to determine which laws, if any, apply to us. And here's the three ways. The first is that the law is separated into three categories: moral, civil, and ceremonial. We say the moral applies, but there's a problem with this. The Old Testament just doesn't make that distinction. Now, you can hold on to any one of these three. I'm not sure any of them are totally perfect, but just be mindful that when the author of Hebrews is saying that the Old Covenant is gone, he doesn't say just the ceremonial part. He's saying 8 through 10, this thing is gone. This thing is gone, because he doesn't seem to make those distinctions. It can be helpful. I'm not persuaded that's the best way to understand Old Testament law. Number two, all of the Old Testament laws are in place unless the New Testament repeals it. Now, that's a little bit tricky when it comes to farming and clothing, because those rules are not repealed in the New Testament. You know, all the rules about how you're supposed to farm, taking time off, 7 years, 50 years, giving the land a break, those things are not ever repealed in the New Testament. Third option, and this happens to be the one I hold to loosely, but nevertheless, none of the Old Testament laws apply unless the New Testament reiterates. That's how I think we deal with these laws. They're gone. We aren't under that law. We're not under the law anymore. We are under grace. Now, you feel a little queasy about that. Wait a second, what do I do with all of those things? Well, you rightly understand what they were written, where they were written for, and you really take it law by law, not section by section, to figure out the principle that carries forward to our day. So, thou shalt not murder. We're not under the Mosaic law, which contains the Ten Commandments. But does that mean we get to murder? No. Why not? Well, it's reiterated elsewhere in the Bible, whether it's with the covenant people or not. Second of all, we know that that's a principle that God has for all time. So we're not done. We're not unhitching from the Old Testament at all. There is much to be learned about Jesus Christ. There is much to be learned about the character and the nature of God. We see this progressive unfolding revelation. We just need to make sure that we are handling these laws rightly. Those are three ways to handle the law, and it's debatable which is best. Figure out your own, and I wouldn't call you a heretic.